With 9 million dog owners in Britain today, many of them are battling to be top dog at home.
Look, you can't go behind me.
But one man believes there's no such thing as a naughty dog.
I'm not going near her.
Just struggling owners.
Swamsy, enough!
You think you've got a problem now, and you have. You're really not in control.
And that's when master dog trainer Graeme Hall steps in to take on the nation's dog owners.
Whoa, whoa, whoa!
I've worked with almost every breed of dog and all kinds of dog behaviour problems, but 9 times out of 10, it's the owners that need to change their behaviour. And that is a really tough message to get across. The problem I got with you is what you're not doing is any sort of correction at all.
With 12 years' experience, Graham's been put to the test thousands of times.
Come on, let's run.
And the results speak for themselves.
No.
Well done, baby.
Well done.
Honestly, it'll change my life.
In his canine casebook this week, a hyper hound leaving his owner with a tough decision to make.
If I can't find a fix, do we rehome him?
I've got to say, you got the wrong dog, really, I think.
And in Chessington, two uncontrollable Akitas.
They just change into these little demons.
Poised for attack.
Oi, come on, Yumi.
But Graham's first port of call is in Liverpool, where the Galloways live with their three lively dogs. Smidge, Heidi, and their newest arrival, Pippa, who's the biggest troublemaker of all. This wily Whippet Patterdale cross is a highly accomplished food thief.
She's eating chicken carcass, she's eating a packet of croissants, she eats rice cakes, a packet of meringues.
Sausages, anything that's available, she will take.
But I know if I leave anything out, it just will not be there when I come back. It's really annoying.
It's an absolute nightmare because you've always got dogs under your feet.
But there's a serious side to Pippa's food thieving ways.
It's like a switch. She just completely goes berserk.
Come on, let me come out of the way.
Her terrifying temper comes out.
No, that's not yours.
When she's guarding her stolen stash.
No, come on. Give me that.
And the family are divided on how to deal with Pippa.
What I'll tend to do is get the ball thrower, put that down on the floor, she then attacks that, and then I can either kick the food away or grab it quickly before she bites me. No! 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 Give it here. Last weekend, she bit me Saturday and Sunday.
While John is willing to go to war to stop Pippa swallowing something which could kill her, no. Joe's taking a much softer approach.
Come on, no, get down. No, get down. Come on, down. She goes into this, like, stop move. Pippa! And goes ready, ready, still. And then, you know, that's the warning signs to say, leave me alone, otherwise I'm going to go for you.
Mum's trick is to bribe the beast with treats.
She's guarding that tuna now. Some tactic is to try and distract her with other food.
When Pippa's not aggressively guarding grub, she's aggressively guarding the front door.
When someone knocks on the door, Pippa goes berserk.
And as soon as Pippa kicks off, her two partners in crime roar down the house.
When the window cleaner comes, she just goes absolutely berserk. She's literally frothing at the mouth to get at him. There's literally nothing that I can say to her to make her stop.
Any noise outside, somebody shuts a car door, a leaf falls off a tree in Warrington, she's at the door or at the window barking.
The family's been living in canine chaos since Mum Jo came to Pippa's rescue.
I help out with various animal charities. Pippa was given into a vet to be put down by her original owners from when she was a puppy. So I said I would foster her for a couple of weeks, and that was 4 years later.
But with Pippa's aggression only getting worse, Jo fears for her family's safety.
If she badly bites anyone, then I'd have to have her put to sleep, and the thought of it makes me just want to cry because she's such a lovely dog.
What I do know about Pippa is that she's a Patterdale Terrier crossed with a Whippet. Now, Patterdales, in particular, they're quite feisty little dogs, so they were bred up in the hill countries of the Lake District, and really to kill foxes, so they can be pretty tough little things. Judging by the behaviour, I guess this is Pippa. Hello, you. Hello. Nice to meet you. Oh, hello. Thank you very much. Oh, hello.
Come on, in.
Hello. Nice to meet you. Hiya.
Let's go in.
Come on.
Let's go in.
Well, that was a spectacular welcome. Well, you seem friendly. Is that normal?
Yeah, very much so. Or anyone walking past the house, they start going berserk.
Oh, right.
Pippa is sort of the ringleader. Always the case when anyone knocks on the door, they just go absolutely berserk.
Yeah, yeah.
Having witnessed Pippa's aggression at the front door, now Graeme wants to hear about her other big problem.
When it comes to food, she's a thief, so she'll pinch anything she finds.
Right.
And if you try and get it off her, she will really go for you.
Yeah.
I just worry that something maybe has happened to her when she was a pup, where she wasn't getting fed properly, or she had to fight for food, or
yeah,
something like that, maybe, is the...
It's interesting because often when dogs have been stray on the streets, you get these behaviours, you know, because they revert to that wild way of scavenging for food, and if they find something, that's pretty valuable.
It's a high-value treat, yeah.
Right, so we've got two problems, really. We've got barking at visitors and frightening the life out of them.
Yeah.
And we've got what happens when she steals food and threatens you and would bite you, given half a chance.
Yeah, she will.
So, pretty big problems, really.
While they've been discussing the problem, Pippa's managed to pinch a packet of pastries.
Right, here we go.
Come here. Come on. Come on. Give me that.
As John dives in to rescue the remains, Graeme gets to see how he handles the problem.
Whoa, come here. Careful.
All right, all right.
Except it's not all right, is it?
No, no,
no. Away from that. Come on. Come on. Come on, give me.
Come on, Pip.
With Pippa wolfing down the lot, John tries to save her from swallowing the plastic bag.
She's going to eat the bag.
John.
Oh,
John!
Right. That was quite a fight, wasn't it? And her tail's down, look.
All right, Pip. Come on. Did she catch her?
Yeah. She caught you?
It's all right. There's no blood this time.
So you've been bitten before doing that, then?
Oh, quite a few times, yeah.
I'm guessing she wouldn't normally eat the bag by choice, but she got herself into such a frenzy.
And it distresses me so much to watch when John's doing that. I just get so upset.
For me there, she couldn't think straight because she got into that crazy frenzy state. You're doing your best, but yeah, it's a battle. I wouldn't go as far as to say you won it, if I'm honest with you. Jo, how would you do it, though?
I wouldn't be able to get it off her. I wouldn't even try because I know she'd go for me and I'm too scared. If it's something she really shouldn't have, I'll get the cereal out and try and throw the cereal at her. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't.
Well, this is about as serious as it gets, because not only could somebody get badly bitten, but Pippa nearly choked on that plastic bag. My real worry is that I might have come too late.
Coming up, not one to be defeated, Graeme has to give it his best shot as he attempts to teach Pippa the meaning of the word no.
Oi!
And Graeme meets a Jack Russell cross, putting his owner in real danger every time they leave the house.
Bobby!
All right.
Yeah, yeah.
Today, Graham's in Liverpool to help the Galloway family with their highly aggressive food-stealing pooch, Pippa.
Last weekend, she bit me Saturday and Sunday.
While John is willing to go to war with Pippa, Mum Jo is too terrified to intervene.
when she either goes into this mode.
I'm scared of her.
Having learned how John and Joe deal with the issue, Graeme's keen to tell them where they've been going wrong.
So there's different ways of tackling it, and I think you couldn't be further apart when it comes to tactics. One of you, I'm afraid, is making it a lot worse.
And there we go.
It's you, John.
Oh,
really? It's you.
Seriously?
Because you're putting a lot of excitement into it, yeah? You're almost creating the fight. You're getting it back off her to some extent, and maybe even you would say most of the time, but still it's getting worse and worse. Because every time it starts again, it's like, they're definitely going to take stuff off me. Because dogs are a bit like us. When you get too excited, you don't think straight. Yeah. You make bad decisions. So we need to train with a bit of calmness, put in a command, perhaps, that'll cut through when she's a bit excited.
Graeme believes that Pippa's frenzied aggression is fueled by confrontation.
No, come on.
But before he can tackle the food problem, he needs to get Pippa to understand the no command. So he's starting with her aggressive guarding at the front door.
I want to start the training with Mum, Joe, who's less of a threat, because John just riles Pippa up, and I want her to be as calm as possible so that she can take in the training. So I'm going to create a no-go zone in this area so we can all see, including her, where the line is. The rule to the dogs is you don't come through here.
OK.
If there's a knock at the door, I'm here to say no and go back. So the face, the body language, everything, calmly but firmly, says no, and I might well block one side to the other, right? So I'm not physically pushing her back, I'm going, I'm herding her, basically, backwards, right? As soon as she gets back through the line, I flick the switch, and I go the other way. Oh, good girl, that's very nice. So the face lights up, but the praise is really calm as well. What I don't want to do is excite her, because in your case, excitement's the last thing you need.
Yeah.
Right, shall we go for it? Let's see what happens. Oi! No. So now she's barking, because she's not sure about me. So I told her off, so I didn't even get as far as saying no. I just went, oi, and that was enough. No. So I'm very precise.
Yeah, yeah.
As soon as the first paw crosses that line, no.
Okay.
What if I help her knocks the door again? No. Good. So already, without an awful lot of effort, we've gone from ballistic to, I'm not happy. Yeah. A bit of a grumble, but we can live with that
for
now.
Yeah, definitely.
And that will go, actually.
A grumble will be fine.
Well, look, I was inclined to say I'll do it again, but I think you should, Joe.
Okay.
Here we go.
Oh, she's coming up.
Hello.
No. No. No.
So use that leg to herd her back this way.
No.
That's it.
Good girl, Pippa.
After a few attempts...
No.
Oh, good girl.
Pippa soon learns to obey with a command.
No.
Swing your leg round.
No.
A block and a bit of praise.
Good girl.
For backing off.
Good girl, Pippa.
If you think about where we've come from, actually, more than good, really good. But there's more to come.
With a clear command and block, Jo has got Pippa to respect a boundary without confrontation. But how will she fare when Pippa gets to the door first?
You're on. You know what to do.
No. Good girl, Pippa. Good girl. Good girl, Pippa.
That's it.
Good girl.
Congratulations, you're a dog trainer. There you go.
I'm really pleased at how it's gone. Obviously, it's going to be harder with the food, but...
It's a really good start.
It's a start, yeah. It's a real start. I feel positive.
The training today has gone very well. She's clearly understood the no command and she's backing off. Next time, it's going to be a different kettle of fish, though, and I'm a bit worried about it, if I'm honest. That behaviour with the food is pretty extreme.
But before Graeme can tackle Pippa's food aggression, he's taking on Bobby, a Jack Russell cross who's putting his owner at risk every time they leave the house.
Walking him is definitely the worst part of my day. He doesn't walk in a straight line. He doesn't like traffic, so he lunges at cars.
Bobby! Stop!
We nearly got hit by a bus. And that was a terrifying experience, utterly terrifying. And I think it compounded how bad things have gotten with him.
While even the most seasoned dog walker would struggle with Bobby, Lee battles more than most.
I was diagnosed in 2013 with, it's a bit of a mouthful, rapidly evolving, relapsing, remitting multiple sclerosis. The symptoms I suffer with my MS is constant pain, fatigue, muscle and limb weakness, vision problems. My hands are losing grip on things. It's just a battle to get through the day sometimes.
Getting a dog was supposed to help with Lee's MS.
I was in a dark place, I'd say. So my mum suggested a dog, which I thought was a great idea. I just absolutely fell in love with him.
But Bobby's restlessness is making her condition much worse.
Having MS, it just... The stress, firstly, exacerbates everything. I don't like being outside with him, but I don't always like being at home with him either.
My mum's at the door.
Is Nana at the door?
I actually thought that having a dog would be a good companion and given a condition, I think, and to manage that stress element. Just having an animal there, they are normally quite relaxing.
15 Bobby. Months on, it's clear her mum Jay's great idea has backfired. With Bobby's hyper behaviour seriously affecting her health, Lee's got a tough decision to make.
I don't know how we fix this. Do we rehome him? If I can't find a fix or a workaround for his behaviour, I think I would have to put myself first. I've run out of options. Unless he changes, I can't continue to look after him.
Jack Russells are really hyperactive dogs, and so they need a lot of exercise to burn off that excess energy. And if an owner struggles with that, then they can be an absolute nightmare to handle and train. You must be late. I'll come in, shall I? Yeah. Hello. Nice to meet you. So, tell me about the problem then, Lee.
Okay. He pulls me into traffic.
Oh, that's not good.
No. Walking is hell. We either have to go at ridiculous times in the morning, like 5 o'clock, and then really late at night,
right,
just to avoid traffic.
So why did you get him in the first place?
It's got my mother to thank for that.
All right.
She just said, well, it would mean that you have to go out of the house at least twice a day to walk him.
Right.
Exercise is a big, almost like a pain reliever on top of the medication that I take.
So tell me about your condition then.
So it's the form of multiple sclerosis where you have periods of prolonged disability, I suppose.
Yeah.
So in those periods, I've lost the sight of my eye. I lost the use of my left side of my body for about 8 weeks. I've lost use of my hands. I try and look after myself, but stress can kind of override all of that.
Right.
And Bobby, unfortunately, is a big stress factor for me. Mm.
Before Graeme can help, he needs to see the problem firsthand.
Oh. Bobby!
You all right?
Yeah.
The busier the road gets, the more anxious Bobby becomes.
So how are you feeling after that? Just
my heart is pounding. I am so... My stress levels are... They've peaked.
Right.
But the pain gets to the point where I can't walk.
Right. So because of the way he is, because of that stress, that makes the pain get worse?
Yeah.
And then you can't walk him?
Yeah.
And then he gets more hyped up in the house?
He does.
And what I'm seeing is once he starts to get into this state, he's getting worse and worse and worse.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm a bit nervous myself walking along with you here. I don't want you to come to any harm. Let's go back into the park and we'll have a chat.
OK.
All right.
Let's go, Babs.
So, good lad. So you got this little fella to help you with your MS.
Mm.
I've got to tell you, you got the wrong dog, really, I think.
Yeah, it feels like it.
Let me tell you a bit about the breed. So Jack Russells were kind of bred for, really for fox hunting, for flushing them out for the hunters,
right.
And they're like on the go all the time. So they're like super energetic in the field and they would keep going for hours and hours on end. And you can see why that's not terribly well suited to you.
Hindsight's a wonderful thing, isn't it?
In it. All we can do is say, look, that is him, and he needs to get out walking regularly every day, burning off some of that energy so that he can think straight. Shall we?
Yeah, sure.
Need to keep walking. The stakes are always high when I get called out, but if I can fix this, it'll have a huge impact on Lee's quality of life. But if I fail, the future looks bleak for both her and Bobby.
And coming up, Graeme takes on two Akitas with a lust for blood.
If they were to grab hold of a small dog, it could easily kill it.
Today, Graham's in Sheffield to help MS sufferer Lee with her hyperactive Jack Russell, Bobby. Having rescued him to help her stay active, something which can improve her condition, Lee's discovered...
The pain gets to the point where I can't walk.
He's making her worse.
Unless he changes, I can't continue to look after him.
This dog's got to be brought to heel, but with Lee's weakness in her hands, it's a major issue. So I've got to find a way of bringing Bobby under control without Lee having to yank on the lead.
To give Lee more control, Graeme is replacing the lead.
Hello there. What's this then? The problem with these is it requires a lot of grip strength, actually, to hold on. But when you've got a dog who really pulls, there's just a chance that you're going to lose him.
Okay.
Whereas if that's wrapped around your hand in the right way, then he can't escape. And you can afford to be confident.
We'll see.
Graeme wants to prove to Lee she doesn't need a lot of strength to keep control. A well-timed, gentle flick of the lead can be enough to send a clear signal.
Now he's starting to go, look. So if I give him a little flick to catch him...
OK.
That's telling him, no, that's out of bounds, you know? He's doing it again, look. Ah. Good boy, that's super. It's nothing big and brutal or nasty, nothing's going to hurt him. Just enough to let him know, no. You see, that was the lightest of touches there.
Yeah.
The trick is to send the signal before Bobby gets wound up and to back it up with a voice command.
And I'm saying no or at the same time. So no. Good boy, that's super. We want to keep a lid on the excitement. We want it calm.
Yeah, that makes sense.
So your praise needs to be calm too. So at. Good boy.
Having shown her how it's done, Graeme wants Lee to give it a go.
So if we carry on up. Good boy.
Good boy.
That's very nice.
Good boy.
That's it. And you wouldn't want your praise to be any more excited than that.
OK.
Yep. Good lad. How's that feel?
Better.
Yeah.
I don't feel like my arm's about to fall off, that's for sure.
And it's relaxed, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
Having quickly got to grips with the techniques, Graeme wants to up the ante.
I've arranged for somebody to come along on a cycle. Come on, off we go. We've got training to do, young man.
Good
See this cyclist coming towards us?
Yes.
This is it.
OK.
So, carry on walking as normal, and let's aim to get past. But if he does react, you know what to do. That's
good
it.
Good
Very good. Keep going. OK, interesting. So instead of launching towards her now, he's kind of going, OK, Mum, I'll just hang behind if you don't mind. That was good, wasn't it?
It was, yeah. Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you what, let's go back up the top. We'll do it again.
OK.
Yep. There we go. Ooh, watch your arm.
Oh, damn it.
Before they tackle the dangerous main road, Graeme wants to make sure Bobby's low-key response wasn't a fluke.
Keep moving. He's trying to move away, look, bless him. Look at that. Now, that's the
good
response
boy.
I want now. Before, you were anxious, stressed out. You know, and it was written all over your face, really.
Oh,
but now it's like a weight's been lifted.
It does kind of feel that way, especially because I'm not so tense.
Yeah.
I feel like we could enjoy a walk like this.
Great. Well, that's music to my ears.
Lee's made great progress in the park, but can she hold her nerve on the busy road when Bobby is at his most anxious?
Good. So, exactly the same as in the park. The thing is, he's on the car side now, so you're going to have your wits about you, but... And remember, while he's being a good boy, every now and again...
Good boy.
But don't rev him up. Nice and calm with the praise.
Good
so it's
boy.
Very much good boy. Now he's getting... That's it. Well done.
Good boy.
So, now, yawn there, that's a little stressy thing.
Is it?
So that's telling me that he's seen cars go past and he's like, I'm not happy.
OK.
But he's not reacting badly. That's the point.
OK.
So he's not comfortable, and we know he's not comfortable in these situations, but he's learning not to react to it.
Yeah.
How about this?
That's remarkable.
There's a motorbike, but you keep moving, so just go slow. I mean, slow, but keep going. Now, there's a motorbike right alongside
you.
No. That's it.
No. No.
That's it. Keep moving.
No.
There you go. Don't speed up, because he wants to run away now, because he's scared of that motorbike.
I feel like I want to run away.
Now the traffic
as well.
Light's going green, so that bike's going to come past you. So just slow down, but keep moving. Let's see what happens. Right. Noisy motorbike.
No.
Fantastic.
Good boy. Good
well
boy.
Done.
Good boy.
Right, let's stop here, I think. How do you feel about that?
That was shocking that he didn't go for it.
Yeah.
I am in a state of shock. Right, yeah. But now I just kind of feel I'm dead proud of him.
Yeah, well done. Well,
good boy.
Less than 24 hours ago, Bobby's behaviour was so bad, he was triggering Lee's MS. Now, for the first time in 15 months, she can calmly walk him.
It feels great. It really does. I feel like for me, his worst behaviour was the walking, and if the walking can be fixed, then I do feel optimistic about everything else.
I really, really wanted to help Lee with Bobby because he's such a lovely dog and, you know, as she said before, he's an idiot, but I love him and I desperately didn't want her to have to rehome him. They're not out of the woods. They still need to practice and Lee needs to keep that optimistic, sunny outlook and things will be fine. I think they're very much on the track to a happy future.
Boy, that's super. Good lad.
Graham's next destination is Chessington, where he's going to meet Maria, whose two Akitas, Yumi and Yuna, are primed for an all-out attack.
They just change into these little demons.
There's one thing in particular that sets them off.
Come on, Yumi.
They are very, very reactive to other dogs. They're just really strong. When they both start pulling, it gets really, really difficult.
Once they see another dog, these Akitas have one thing on their mind, blood.
Dog, look. Every single dog they come across now, they have that reaction. It's just gradually got worse and worse.
And with the dogs becoming harder to control, Maria holds on to her hounds for dear life.
Georgie, hold the handle in case.
Fearing the worst.
Come on, you're frightening those little puppies. Obviously, these are strong, powerful dogs, so if they were to grab hold of a small dog, it could easily kill it. I always have to drag someone else with me.
But their behaviour is becoming too much for the family.
If we see any other dogs, it's very stressful. Stop. Oi. I don't like being in that situation where, you know, I'm holding them back and it's just not very pleasant for anyone, really.
With these two Akitas remaining impeccably behaved at all other times...
You're not dangerous, are you? Hmm? Not to people, anyway.
Maria fears their killer instinct with other dogs could get them taken away and even put down.
If Graham can't help me, I really don't know where to go from here.
Akitas used to guard Japanese royalty, but also they are fighting dogs. So do these two have a killer instinct, or is it just bluff? I don't know.
Hello,
hello,
Graham.
Maria. Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Come on in. Right. Hello, you
two. My naughty babies.
Come here, then.
Yumi, are you coming?
Yumi, come here.
Yuna.
They're remarkably calm.
They are in the house.
So tell me about the problem then.
The problem is, as soon as they see another dog, they would want to get to the other dog, so they start barking and they start pulling, and it's not easy to control them. If they were able to get to the dog, they would pin it down, jump on it.
Have they managed to get to any animals, like a wildlife or anything like that?
Yumi has caught a fox once. She had it by the neck.
So there's a bit of a killer instinct there.
There is. I think Yumi's the naughty one and Yuna copies her.
Right. Now, the important thing about what I do is I need to see it.
OK.
So shall we go outside and you can show me what you're doing?
Sure.
With Maria unable to walk the dogs on her own, Graham's asked her daughter Georgia along to see how they work together to handle their hounds. And whilst Yumi and Yuna are initially calm and under control, the mood soon changes.
Oh, dog ahead.
There
dog
is,
alert.
You're right. OK.
Having anticipated Yuna and Yumi's reaction to an approaching dog, Maria and Georgia stop and hold their hounds back.
Yuna.
Right.
Yuna. Yuna. Not so calm anymore.
Not so calm anymore,
this
no.
This is what they're like. They're a nightmare. This is why I cannot take them both out on my own.
OK.
Because if I was in charge of both of them and they did that...
Yeah, yeah. I was called out here because we've got two Akitas acting aggressively with other dogs, and that's a really serious proposition. They're not killer dogs, that's for sure. The problem lies elsewhere. I think what I have to tell you is they're not really aggressive dogs. Actually, they're feeding off you.
Oh, really?
If you've ever seen the police training their dogs, they hold on to them while they wind them up. They hold on and they wind them up, they hold on and wind them up. And then they let go and shout attack or a similar command. The only thing you're missing is the word
the
attack.
Let go.
You're doing all the rest of it.
Oh, wow.
I think you're creating your own problem.
I had a feeling you were going to say something like that.
Let's start a bit of training and I'll show you what changes we need to make.
The problem is there's this little part of me that thinks there'll be times where they'll just react. That's the hard bit.
Right. But if I show you what's possible, will you believe it?
Probably.
Probably?
Probably.
OK. There's an undercurrent here of, I don't believe it, I don't believe it's going to work. If you believe it's not going to work, do you know what? It's not going to work. I need to show Maria that this is possible, but it all hangs on whether or not Maria listens to what I have to tell her and puts it into practice.
To stop Maria priming her Akitas for an attack by grabbing their harnesses, Graeme wants to replace them with a lead. Which will allow her to calmly guide the dogs away. But Maria's doubts are already kicking in.
Are you sure it's quite sturdy?
Yeah? I'm sure it is.
It's not going to slip off.
No, I think you're looking for a problem there.
I'm just so used to these. These are so safe.
There we go. Great. The important thing with the collar is it's absolutely not about holding tension and just dragging the dog around, because the more you hold back, the more they pull into the collar, they choke themselves, and it's really not about that.
Mm.
So we need to keep a slack lead.
I don't feel that secure.
Right.
The harness was strong, but I'm sure I'll trust you.
Good.
Graeme is convinced that Yumi and Yuna are not aggressive, and left to their own devices, they wouldn't go on the attack. They just need to be walked calmly and kept moving. To prove the point, Graham's invited a dog along to meet them.
So I'm going to walk towards the dog, but not straight at the dog, because that's confrontational. And if she reacts at any time, I'm going to tell her off, but I won't be stopping and certainly won't be grabbing hold and just holding on, because that causes the problem.
Right.
The vital thing is that I praise her when she's being good.
OK.
It's so easy to forget.
Yeah.
That's the plan. If she sees me doing it, then surely, surely we're there, you'd hope.
And starting with one dog, Yumi.
Good girl, that's super. Yes.
Oh, he's getting closer.
Graeme aims to get right up to the other dog without Yumi reacting.
Yumi is actually really focused on Graeme. She's trotting along and looking at him.
Nice to meet you. Thank you very much. Hello, how lovely are you? Come on, you.
She's just standing next to him.
Very good.
Good girl, was that fun?
So what do you think, Maria?
That was quite impressive, actually. She actually looks like a different dog.
Is this starting to get believable?
I'm not 100% confident right now.
Yeah.
But I'm sure I'll feel better.
Right.
Graeme might have proved that with the right equipment and a firm, confident hand, the dogs will not react.
Come on, Yuna.
Good.
Good girl.
The question is, will Maria hold her nerve when she walks Yuna?
Good girl.
Brilliant. Around the lady.
Come on, this way.
Super. You look great. See?
She didn't even look at the other dog, I don't think,
either. No, it's great. How do you feel?
I feel great.
Look confident.
Yeah, I was slightly, we're getting closer, but then, you know, they carried on walking.
Well, here's the thing. From my point of view, looking from the outside, what's changed is your body language has changed. It didn't look like a lady who was panicking.
Oh, good.
So, are you believing it now?
Yeah.
Good. Excellent.
With Maria's fragile confidence having remained intact, Graeme wants to set Maria a challenge which will really test her, walking both of her Akitas together past not one, but three dogs.
What I need to remember, I think, is not to stop and panic. Hopefully, being optimistic, it will work.
Off you go. Power up.
OK, wish me luck.
Yeah, go on.
Come on.
All the best.
Come on, you two. Come
on. You can do it.
I can do this. Come on, we can do this. Come on, sweetheart. Good girls. Oh, good girls. This way. Come on, that way. Good girls.
So she's been past two dogs now, nothing at all. The last dog has decided to get up and show a bit of interest, which normally would have been a big issue.
Come on, this way. This way.
There's two dogs under control.
Good girl.
Maria. Looks like a different woman, yeah.
Good girl.
How did that feel? Hello, girl.
That felt really well good, done. Yeah. That was really good.
So, you can do this, can't you?
Yeah, we can do this, can't we, puppies?
Last thought for you. Keep believing in yourself.
I'll try. I'll try.
You've done really well today.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Keep up your training.
Bye-bye. Bye.
Well, Maria didn't think that she'd ever be able to walk these two dogs on her own. But with the right techniques, I've shown her that's entirely possible.
I think my confidence has improved. It's just so much nicer to be able to walk two well-behaved dogs.
Coming up, Graham's got unfinished business in Liverpool.
Two in the bag. Oh, John!
With a wily food thief who gets aggressive when her owner lays down the law.
She caught you.
It's all right, there's no blood this time.
Graham's back in Liverpool to help with Pippa, an aggressive Whippet Patterdale cross rescued from death row after she attacked a previous owner.
Pippa was given into a vet to be put down, so I said I would foster her for a couple of weeks. And that was 4 years later.
Graham's discovered that Pippa's aggression over food is triggered by confrontation. Having taught her how to obey a simple no command at the front door, he now wants to apply the same technique to stop her from stealing food.
With any dog problem where something's ingrained, particularly something like aggression, it's very difficult to fix. You know, in Pippa's case, it's hardwired in there. One of the difficulties that we've got is that she really only steals things when you're not in the room.
Yeah.
So how do you train a dog when you can't see what she's doing and you're not there to put a response in anyway?
Yeah.
Very different to the door. Well, I think I might have an answer. So I've got to set something up in your kitchen.
Oh, okay.
And I'll call you through when I'm ready. Is that all right?
Oh, that's fine.
Graham's got a plan to teach a simple no command using her favourite treat with the help of a gadget.
Okay, guys, come on through. So the solution I've come up with a bit of tech help, is this. Doggy cam.
The aim is to stop Pippa stealing in the first place, so there's no need for her to get aggressive.
So I've got a camera and some sausages, so we can watch Pippa in another room and see what she's doing. Now, I think the important thing is timing, because if she gets all the way up here and has three out of the four sausages, and then we try and tell her stop, nothing's going to stop her then. But if we can catch the moment when she goes, I think I'll just, you know, no, then you're potentially on a winner. I want us to think at the end of it that mum's got or dad's got eyes in the back of the heads. You know, it's like, oh, look. Somebody's left the door open. Right, watch. Let's have a look.
Before Graham's even sat down, Pippa's tucking in.
Yeah, we'll have to go there.
But right. Will the no command work with food?
No. No. No.
Pippa's managed to snatch three of the four sausages.
Wait for it.
With one sausage left, it's vital she obeys.
If she comes down, we praise her. Good girl, that's fine.
Yeah. Good girl, Pip.
If she's kind of looking at me going, I'm going to wait until you get bored and I'll have that sausage. And I'm looking at her going, Pippa, darling, I could wait longer than you.
It's a battle of wills.
It's a breakthrough moment. Pippa's learnt that she'll get praise for obeying commands. But will that continue when Joe takes Graham's place?
Just moving to visit. Fairly normal, not in a threatening way.
She's going to go for me.
Watch ya.
But with a clear no command...
No.
No.
Pippa stays put.
Good girl.
Fine.
Leaving the sausage untouched.
So when she started sniffing to work out where it was again, we both threw in a quick no.
Yeah.
She went, okay, I'm on the wrong track. Can you see how this is like the door? Yeah. It's just we have to take a time with this.
Yeah.
Thing. But it's working.
Yeah, you can see. You come down a lot quicker than I thought you would.
Well, let's go back into the living room. And come on, Pippa.
Come on, Pip. Come on, darling.
She's coming out. Great.
Good.
Oh, good girl.
Yeah.
That's super.
The message may be sinking in with Joe, but with John and Pippa usually clashing over food, how will he fare?
Here we go.
Moments of truth.
Any step forward. Now.
No! No! No!
And this is really hard because she's had one. This is where if you rushed her now, she'd beat
she'd
you
She'd go for
it,
you.
And you'd have a huge setback. So this is the moment of truth. Right, get ready, John.
Good girl, Pippa. Good
That's
girl.
It. That's enough. No more excitement. Good girl.
Good girl, Pippa.
Good girl. There you go. Super.
Oh,
Christ. I know, it's lovely, isn't it?
Good girl.
Yeah, look at this.
Good girl.
Just hours ago, Pippa would fight tooth and nail to stop anyone getting between her and her food. And now, with a simple command, the family can stop Pippa stealing treats without her kicking off.
Good girl, Pippa.
It just makes me feel so relieved and pleased and grateful.
You're welcome.
That is, like, totally different than what we normally have.
Checks in the post.
That's all right. I'm a bit emotional because, you know, the stakes couldn't have been higher here. But John and Joe are now working together, and as time's gone on, we've seen a lot more nice Pippa. It's ended really well.
I think we're both on the same page now, aren't we? Absolutely on the same page.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Appreciate all your help.
It's been a pleasure. You lot, be good.
Amazed what he's achieved in such a short time.
He knows what he's doing. He knows his stuff.
In Chessington, Maria's now confidently walking Uni and Yuma without worrying about them attacking other dogs. In Liverpool, Pippa has finally packed in her food-stealing ways. And in Sheffield, Lee and Bobby are finally enjoying the exercise they need. Next time, Graeme faces his biggest challenge. Training a dog that's terrified of men, including him.
I'm not overly keen on getting too much closer.
No, I wouldn't either.
Jack Russell Patch, who has his owners living in fear.
One minute he can be playing, and then the next minute he'll just turn around and bite you.
As we go along, she gets louder.
And Labrador Cross Sophie, who's driving her owner barking mad.
One day, she's going to stress me out so much that I will have an accident.